Good day, and welcome back to another Honkai Star Rail video. In this video, I'm going to talk a little bit about the pity system in Honkai Star Rail so that you guys can have a better understanding of how the pity system works. Now, what is a pity system? Well, pity system refers to the number of pulls, or in this case warps, you need on a banner before you're guaranteed to get a 4-star or 5-star character. However, you can at any time pull a 4-star or 5-star character. So, how does it work? Well, first type of pity that we have in the game is the 10 pull pity. So, for every 10 pulls that you do on the character event warps, like cone warps, regular warps, or the starter warps, you are guaranteed at least one 4-star character or light cone. So that's every single 10 warps, you are guaranteed to have that. Now this can occur on the 6th or 7th, etc., but you are guaranteed to get so. In terms of 5-star characters, 5-star characters will appear every 90 warps on the character feature banner, or every 80 warps on the light cone banner. When you achieve the 90 or 80 character or light cone threshold, you will essentially be given a 50-50 chance at getting the guaranteed featured character. So for example, if you pull 90 times on the character banner for Seal, the first time you get to pull 90, you will have a 50-50 chance of it being Seale. If you fail to get her, then the next time you get to the pity system, you will have Seale guaranteed. So that's kind of a rough basis on how it works. Of course, at any point you can get a 5-star character or a 5-star light cone. Should you get the 5-star character or light cone, the pity will reset regardless of what point you are at. So for example, if you pull a 5-star at pull 20, then you are completely reset and have to go another 90 pulls until you can get your guaranteed. Of course, it can happen at any point, so it's really not guaranteed that you will go 90 summons without getting a 5-star. In fact, that's very unlikely. But it's just to explain how the pity counter works. It will be completely reset every time you hit a 5-star. You can check your records, as I just did, to see what banners, obviously, or how many times you've summoned on a banner to see how close you are to pity. Remember, you have to count from the time you received your last 5-star. In terms of the banners, each banner has its own independent pity counter. The counter for the light cone and character banners are separate, and the permanent banner is separate. Their 10 pull counters are also separate as well. Special mention for the once-off pity on the permanent banner. When you do 300 pulls, you will be able to choose any 5-star that you want. So, now the next question that you're probably wondering is, does pity carry over to the next banner? Well, the event warp banners, that is the character and light cone banners, will carry over the pity. So if, for example, you do not get Seale on this banner, you will carry over any pity you have to the next banner, and you will then have increased chance of getting the 5-star on that banner. What this means is, if you do not get Seale and you do not wish to get the next character as a 5-star, it's probably best that you save and refrain from summoning on that banner. It may sound weird, but it's a way to guarantee carrying over whatever pity you do have, instead of using up potentially that pity on a banner where you don't want the 5-star. It's kind of how people manage their expectations and wait for units they really, really want. Now, of course, pity isn't really how people want to go. Pity is, generally speaking, not a great kind of mechanism to get to. It's really a failsafe more than anything. As you can see as well, a special final mention to how pulling multiple 5-star works. So if, for example, I had pulled a different 5-star from Seale, I would have reset my character and I would have then had a guaranteed chance to get Seale next. Because I pulled Seale first, my next pull of a 5-star will be the 50-50 guaranteed, even though Seale was my first 5-star on the banner. The moment you pull the featured character, the next summon you do will always be the 50-50 chance, not a guaranteed chance. Which means if you get two in a row, you've succeeded at your guaranteed and at your 50-50. And that's basically it. That kind of covers everything you need to know about the pity system. Now, it can be confusing, so if you need any help, you can always ask in the comments down below. For character event warps, it is a 50% chance to get featured characters at the pity mark, whereas on light cone banners, it is 75%. But that's going to be it for me. See you guys next time. Bye.